Hey everyone, welcome back to the second devlog of our cozy little game developed in Godot 4.1 together with my talented girlfriend. Last time I implemented the ground, movement and the camera system. Today I need to have at least some gameplay working and we also need to finalize the game idea. But before that, I just want to add some objects to the level because at the moment it feels a bit empty, don't you think? So let's start by adding some passive objects such as trees, rocks and fences. This should help set that cozy mood we are going for. My amazing artist has drawn some delightful assets, including these lovely trees, bushes, wooden fence posts and a variety of rocks. Importing the sprites is a tad tricky. To ensure our sprite 3D objects always face the camera, I enable the billboard mode. However, I encountered an issue where the base of the sprite wouldn't stay on the ground when the camera was moving. While this behavior is fine for things like projectiles, I want the trees to remain stationary on the ground. To fix this, I disabled the centered checkbox and manually set the base offset in pixels. Now everything looks much better. At the runtime, I noticed when the camera is moving, sprites popping in and out near the edges of the screen. To fix this, I added some extra color margin in the sprite 3D settings. This tells the engine that these objects appear slightly larger on the screen and should not be removed from the draw list too early. I also encountered a minor issue with some bushes overlapping each other in a way that doesn't look too good. While turning off Use AABB Center under sorting helped a bit, it didn't completely fix the problem. If you have any ideas on how to improve this, please let me know in the comments. Fences and rocks have static bodies to prevent the player from passing through them. As for the trees, I decided to leave them without static bodies, to allow players to easily stroll through them without getting stuck. I've often come across games where small impassable trees cause frustration when the player gets stuck. Therefore, I recommend making such objects easily possible. Optionally, you can add a mechanic to slowly push the player out of such objects if they decide to stop inside them. When designing levels, it's essential to have objects of various sizes and place them together to improve the visual composition. This technique greatly enhances the perception and makes the scene more interesting to look at. Big trees, medium rocks and bushes, small grass. It felt nice to play the role of a landscape designer and place all those trees and bushes. Placing the fences was also oddly satisfying. It was like playing a game inside Godot. Game development is surely fun. Initially, I wanted to add some flying butterflies, but what do we say to the god of feature creep? Not today. So I've decided to ditch that idea for now. While I was busy with the level design, my girlfriend finished drawing the vegetables. They look very tasty. They have two frames. The first one is the normal state and the second one is a highlighted state. Now I just need to place vegetables on garden rows scattered around the level. I must say, it's starting to look like a real farm. With our cozy world taking shape, it's time to settle on a game idea. We had several options, from a regular farming game where you plant and harvest crops, to a game where you protect the harvest from ox using traps and a sturdy shotgun. Considering the limited time for the game jam, we opted for a simpler idea. Collecting food for adorable fox puppies. Players will take on the role of a fox and collect vegetables from a local farmer to stash away for the winter. I hope he won't mind much. Of course, to keep things interesting, there will be walking scarecrows protecting the harvest. My talented artist has created the sprite for the fox, consisting of just two frames, one for standing still and one for walking. The scarecrow is also in the works and will be ready by the next devlog, so I'll deal with him then. Additionally, my girlfriend composed the delightful soundtrack you've been listening to in the background, using GarageBand and a MIDI keyboard. It really fits the cozy mood of the game. Instead of creating a full-fledged walking animation, I'm using a simple trick to convey the motion, just a squash animation on the sprite's scale vector, making it lower and wider, and then going back to normal. It's good enough for a game jam. A quick update to the code. I need to add the frame switching depending on the movement input, then I need to flip the sprite horizontally depending on the movement direction. And finally, I'm playing the squash animation when the character is moving. I'm also remembering the last horizontal direction input and using that for the frame flipping. As we wrap up today's progress, I want to thank you all for your support, especially my patrons on Patreon. While I was working on this devlog, I had a short trip to Warsaw to deal with some paperwork. The weather was lovely and I enjoyed walking in the city a lot. I even picked up some souvenirs from an art supply store for my girlfriend. Also, as a bit of other news, I've decided to move from Twitter to Mastodon's game dev community. If you're interested, feel free to follow me there. Thanks again for joining us on this cozy game development journey. The next devlog will be our final one, as it's going to be the last day of the game jam, where we'll finish everything up and get ready to publish the game. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to see the result. Alright, that's all for today. Take care and see you next time.